Hello YouTube, Otaku Dibyan here, and today we are reviewing Lupin III CGI movie which has just come out. It will be an honest and factual review with no spoilers, so without further ado, let's begin. At first we will discuss about the production quality of the movie, which is pretty great. For real deep analysis, we got a nerd friend with us today, Vikram Saha. He is a very good friend of mine. So Vikram, what's your thoughts about this?
Oh yeah, the production quality, right?
Yeah.
The being a CG anime, I didn't hope it would be that good. Usually CG anime made by Disney are pretty terrible, you know?
Yeah, the Sonic movie.
Yeah, but by terrible, I mean, you know, they try to make everything more realistic than it should be.
Yes.
Like, look at Sonic's hair. He's a cartoon character. He shouldn't have real hair, you know.
Yeah.
Like a real hedgehog. But what I really like about this movie in particular is that they maintained the original art style of Monkey Punch.
Yeah, actually that was pretty awesome. We got that Doraemon movie named Stand By Me, with also the same production.
Yeah, they have the same director, so. And the CG just doesn't look justice to the art style. It looked gorgeous, like everything was so shiny and beautiful. Like, Jesus, just look at the opening, man.
Yeah, that was pretty awesome.
Look at this.
I also like that. So let's talk about the author now. We will discuss about the author whose name was Kazuhiko Kato, aka Monkey Punch. He actually passed away recently at 2019. The month was April, I guess, and I am not sure about the day. My bad. So what are your thoughts about the author particularly?
The author, Monkey Punch, is actually famous for writing adult comics. By adult, I don't mean porn straight up. I mean,
it's
different than porn because it has you know, good content, you know.
Yeah, adventure,
great, the characters are great. You know, it's like a James Bond movie basically. Will have some few x-rated scenes, so
few kids can adult watch. Scenes, but the story is great as usual.
But the don't worry, the anime doesn't have any
this movie, and also the anime also.
The movie is actually PG-13, so teenagers can watch it with their parents.
No problem with that. Let's talk about the manga now. I actually haven't read the manga, that's why you are with us. Tell everything you know.
No, I am not an expert in this session. I do read a lot of manga, but I haven't actually read many Monkey Punch stuff. Before watching the movie, I was going through the manga. What I can say is research. That the manga is actually pretty different from the anime.
Okay.
So the first manga, Lupin 3, which was written, is the original source. Then the anime came out. Now the anime followed the manga a little bit, but not very much.
So how does it differ?
Later Lupin 3, Shin Lupin 3 came out, which is actually serialization of the anime, not the original manga. So Shin Lupin 3 is actually different than Lupin 3. And then there are other sub-series, other stuff. There's a lot of stuff actually to read about Lupin.
Was that adult or it is?
Yeah,
like
I said.
How much adult it was?
Also, pretty much every chapter has some you know, adult content in it.
Wow, that's weird because I have watched the anime and I haven't noticed anything which is that adult. I think that nudity.
It has some. Not to mention, there are some. It also tends to get pretty dark sometimes. Like, Lupin straight up shoots people.
You mean that gore content?
No, not gore. By gore, I mean like in the movies, Lupin is pretty sympathetic about not killing people, alright? Okay. But he will kill if it's only necessary.
Killing people.
But this manga, he just, you know, if he's a bad guy, he just straight up shoot 5 bullets at him.
Okay, but yeah. Guys, quick alert, we can't show the HC pages with full nude content, but I am showing some of the pages from the manga and become... Okay, let's continue. Continue your speech about the manga.
Okay, and also, as I said, and also about the art style, you might think this art style looks weird, but this is not actually weird because it was written in the 70s. This is not absurd because it was made in the 80s. Just look how many 80s
manga
have.
Compared to that different time, art it style. Is normal. It was normal.
Actually. Yeah. Just look at Devilman's manga. Look at
the first art old
style. It doesn't look same as the anime.
So let's talk about the anime now. Actually, do you know something about the anime?
No, I haven't watched any of the anime.
I recently watched three episodes of the 2015 series, which also have a movie with the same storyline. The animation was also very nice. You should watch the anime. It's really good, actually.
And if you're thinking of picking up the manga, I would say read from the start. Read the original Lupin III, 1970.
Which was written 1970, and same goes for anime. I think there is no certain series actually or seasons that you should start with. Anime you can start from everywhere. I guess I actually started with 2015, and that's not a problem because these series are not connected that much to each other. But you also have the character storyline, especially like the Jigen, Goemon, Fujiko have their respective storyline dedicated to themselves only. So if you are interested, you can check that also. And no, I don't think there is some serial content. Serial system of watching the anime. You can start from anywhere. We are really recommending this movie. I think this is the best CGI movie I have ever watched. What are your thoughts about that?
I actually couldn't hear you. It got cut for some reason.
Okay, no problem. I actually talking about the recommendation of the movie.
Definitely recommend the movie. And also the movie's full name is Lupin III, the First. This is there will probably be more Lupin Third CG movies in the future.
Yeah,
which I'm very excited about.
Yeah, actually it was the first movie I have watched at cinema hall. In India, anime movies are only streaming at PVR. Timing is pretty weird and very less to me. And that was actually one day.
Yeah, so anime in India is pretty rare actually. Only recently, because of the popularity of the Dragon Ball Super movie, companies have been trying to get anime in India since it got a massive response. Not just massive, actually the author, the creator, the writer, actually they are the same people, of Kimi no Na wa and also the Tenki no Ko movie. Came in India himself to promote his movies.
Wow.
The movie Tenki no Ko, which was pretty big at that time. The halls were jam packed during the Tenki no Ko screening.
I haven't watched the Tenki no Ko actually.
Anyway, because of the massive popularity it got, anime movies are actually making a pretty. Anime movies are actually getting pretty famous in here. So yeah.
Yeah, so that's good for us.
But Lupin 3 doesn't really have a fan base in India.
Yeah, that's
so
really.
Halls were actually relatively pretty empty, which is sad. And it was further.
We should actually
because of the coronavirus.
We ourselves also haven't watched the movie earlier, and we should also recommend this after watching this series. I think if you are recommending something to others, they will ask you about this review, kind of review that about that series. And you, if you don't watch this series, how can you give the review to them? No, so in order to grow the fan base, you have to first watch by yourself the series or whatever you are recommending. So Vikram, I think we should call it a day.
Yeah.
So guys, thanks for watching. Like this video, comment if you have any question in your mind. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more contents like this.
Also watch my video nothing.mp4.
Yeah, I will drop the link in my description. Do check this, take Vikram's channel if you are if you don't have any work to do. Let's go. Peace.